Hello students, in this session I am continuing with the second part of the French Revolution. Now the topic begins with, did women have a revolution? From very beginning, women were active participants in the events. Most women of the third state had to work for a living. Most women did not have access to education. Only daughters of nobles or wealthier members of the third state could study. After that, they got married. Working women had also to care for their families and to do household work. To voice their interest, women started their own political clubs and newspapers. About 60 women's clubs came up. The Society of Revolutionary and Republican Women was the most famous club. Their main demands were right to vote, to be elected to the assembly, and to hold political office. Laws introduced by revolutionary government for women. The revolutionary government did introduce laws for women. Number one is the creation of state schools. Number two is schooling was made compulsory for all girls. Number three, their fathers could no longer force them into marriage against their will. Number fourth is marriage was made into a contract and registered under civil law. Number fifth is divorce was made legal. Number sixth is women could now train for jobs. During the Reign of Terror, the Jacobin government issued laws ordering closure of women's clubs and banning their political activities. Many prominent women were arrested and a number of them executed. Women's movement for voting rights and equal wages continued for 200 years in many countries. Finally, in 1946, the women in France won the right to vote. The abolition of slavery in France. The most revolutionary social reforms of the Jacobin regime was the abolition of slavery in the French colonies. Europeans were reluctant to go to unfamiliar lands, meant a shortage of labor on the plantations. So, this was met by a triangular slave trade between Europe, Africa, and America. French merchants sailed from the ports of Bordeaux or Nantes to the African coast, where they bought slaves from local chieftains. Branded and shackled, the slaves were packed tightly into ships for long voyage across the Atlantic to the Caribbean. There they were sold to plantation owners. The exploitation of slaves met the growing demand in European markets. Port cities like Bordeaux and Nantes owed their economic prosperity to the flourishing slave trade. The National Assembly held long debates about whether the rights of man should be extended to all French subjects. But it did not pass any laws fearing opposition from businessmen. In 1794, the convention legislated to free all slaves in the French overseas possessions. Napoleon reinforced slavery. Finally, in 1848, slavery was abolished in French colonies. Now, let's study about the revolution and its effects on everyday life. 1789 in France saw many such changes in the lives of men, women, and children. The revolutionary government passed laws to practice liberty and equality into everyday practice. One important law came into effect was the abolition of censorship of king on all written material and cultural activities. The Declaration of Rights proclaimed freedom of speech and expression to be a natural right. Newspapers, pamphlets, and books flooded in France. Freedom of speech also meant that opposing views of events could be expressed. Plays, songs, and festive processions attracted people. This way, they could grasp ideas of liberty or justice that political philosophers wrote about and a handful of educated people could read. Now, let's know about Napoleon Bonaparte. In 1804, Napoleon Bonaparte crowned himself Emperor of France. He set out to conquer neighboring European countries, dispossessing dynasties and creating kingdoms where he placed members of his family. Napoleon saw his role as a modernizer of Europe. He introduced many laws such as number 1, the protection of private property, number 2, a uniform system of weights, number 3, measures provided by the decimal system. Initially, many saw Napoleon as a liberator who would bring freedom for the people. But soon, the Napoleon armies viewed everywhere as an invading force. He was finally defeated at Waterloo in 1815. And the last is conclusion. Napoleon measures that carried the revolutionary ideas of liberty and modern laws to other parts of Europe had an impact on people long after he had left. The ideas of liberty and democratic rights were the most important legacy of the French Revolution. These spread from France to the rest of Europe during the 19th century, where feudal system were abolished. Colonized people reworked the idea of freedom from bondage into their movements to create a sovereign nation state. Tipu Sultan and Raja Ram Mohan Roy are two examples of individuals who responded to the ideas coming from revolutionary France. I hope you have understood the chapter. Thank you.